To begin with, hi, my name is Gaurav, and I run a nonprofit. My nonprofit is called Slam Out Loud. It uses arts to create safe spaces for children. And then these spaces empower children to build 21st century mindsets and values. And through these values, they find better opportunities to thrive in life. This is what I do at the core of it. And through our work, we are trying to unpack what does having a safe space mean? Why have safe spaces? And how do we equip ourselves as individuals to create those spaces for everyone around us? The next 10-12 minutes, I'll be sharing the journey of my learning. And I hope within that will be some takeaways that you can use in your everyday life for people that you work with, for people that you are around. Before we begin, I invite you to do a small memory jog with me. I want you to close your eyes. With the eyes closed, think about a time when you felt challenged due to the environment around you. Challenged in a way that inhibited you from growing, sharing, and participating. It can be because of the people around, the space design, certain actions, verbal, non-verbal cues, things that made you feel threatened, explicit or implicit norms. It can be a physical space, you in company of few people, or a virtual space like Facebook or internet, where you are just trying to show a presence. Take a few moments to think about the feeling you had. Try giving it a word. Take the next few moments to just stay with that feeling. Three, two, one. You may open your eyes. I'll push you a little bit. Turn to the person sitting next to you and talk about what that feeling was. Okay, let's come back. And five, four, three, two, one. Now think of a space that actually makes you feel that you can thrive. Think of a space that enables you to be your best self, that brings out the best in you. Think about the people who surround you within that space. What do they do? What do they say? What are the verbal, non-verbal cues that you pick up on? What do you feel empowered to do? Most of the times, these spaces are the people that we have been closest with. These are the people who hold these spaces where we can be vulnerable, know each other better, know ourselves better, and enjoy the company that we are in. Oxford Dictionary defines safe space as a place or an environment in which a person or a group of individuals can feel confident that they will not be exposed to discrimination, unhealthy criticism, harassment, or any other physical or emotional harm. And when you are thinking about the safe spaces, about the space when you had your eyes closed, I'm sure a lot of things that you thought about resonate with the definition, with the words written in red. You felt either discriminated, exposed to criticism, or undue harassment. The world we are living in is very connected and diverse. We are perhaps in the time when we are the most connected in the cycle of evolution. But the important thing is to understand why safe spaces matter. The quest to understand this and answer to this question will take us down the path when we were Stone Age dwellers from a tribe in Africa living in jungles, to the journey we have had in the past 2.5 million years. Evolution holds the key to understanding why safe spaces are so important as of now. In the past 2 million years, we have lived through gradually changing environments that have offered very distinct dangers. Think about the earliest ancestors we had. Their threats were very tangible. They could be eaten up by a predator. They could be killed by a deadly disease. They were facing harsh weathers. The conditions are not so harsh as of now. We are living in relatively safer environments. We have architectural marvels that save us from the weather. We have invented medicines that save us from harm, deadly diseases. However, what we have also done through our evolution is morph our fear or sense or our ability to sense that fear in a very different fashion. Earlier, if lion was there who was making us feel threatened, today our bosses might not be eating us, but might make us feel threatened to a very similar degree. We can feel the similar degree of anxiety. We might be feeling a very palpable fear when we are inside a boardroom. So what has happened? What has happened is, although we have evolved from having very tangible fears that could cause death to a fear that makes us feel a very similar feeling in a very different space. And that is when, and that is where the concept of safe spaces comes in. Safe spaces make us feel safe inside an environment, irrespective of where we are. It is also important to understand that as we have evolved, we have also held a very strong ability to create these spaces for ourselves and others. I can, by the virtue of creating a space, make a space inclusive or non-inclusive. It might be inclusive for a segment of population and then non-inclusive for others. I can, by the virtue of being a creator of that space, induce certain elements, certain laws, certain rules, a vocabulary that would make some people feel very threatened. By the very specific examples I use, I can make that space make people feel safe because though my inclusive, or I could exclude certain people within that space. And this is the first realization as to why we need this whole conversation around safe spaces, to understand that we have this ability to be able to do that to each other. On internet, it's very rampant. We are seeing people trolling each other left, right, center. And it has become so common. Like, I can violate someone's safe space by a comment, by a GIF now, by a meme. And once we understand and have awareness about this ability, we can delve deeper into understanding why even more creating safe space is important. I was a teacher for a class of 50 girls for 2 years as a part of my Teach for India fellowship. I was teaching in a government school. My children came from some of the most challenging communities in Delhi. These communities were marred with lack of basic facilities, lack of hygiene, lack of security. Their parents had uneven and really low incomes. And the initial months of being a teacher were very challenging. I walked in with my own pre-assumptions. And within my role for the first couple of months, what I did made me realize the power that I held. I was mostly learning or working from my own understanding of how education had worked for me. So my teachers would be favoring children who are academically higher, making an example out of them, trying to sideline children who do not know much or are academically not so achieving, setting up the bars for success, same for everyone. And that's what I was doing. And unknowingly, it was just me operating with my own lack of awareness. One fine day after 2 months, I asked my class to give me an anonymous feedback. And within that, 11-year-olds called out how insensitive I was at times to be able to set those bars of success for everyone. It pushed me to think of my own role as a teacher. It was yes, of course, of teaching a group of 50 kids, but beyond that, it was also to create a space where everyone, every child of my class, irrespective of how much they scored, what context they came from, what their background was, felt safe to voice an opinion. That was the first learning I had. My eyes opened up to a very different aspect of me. And that is the power that we all hold when we are playing a role of a friend, an entrepreneur, an educator, a mentor, or a person just in charge of crafting a space. Safe spaces matter because they offer people, and there are more reasons. Safe spaces matter because they offer people an opportunity to know what freedom of expression and the joy of being listened to looks like. When we create safe spaces, it gives an opportunity for people who feel oppressed in otherwise areas in the society to come in and talk about what they feel. Safe spaces ensure a diversity of perspectives. We all would agree, like, we cannot operate in a society with a singular perspective. We would not have invented the inventions that we are proud of had we always been thinking on the same lines. Safe spaces ensure that the degree of diversity that is required for a creative brain exists in the space that we are parts of. The world we live in is becoming increasingly complex. Our avenues to connect to the world have dramatically increased in the past 15 to 20 years with the internet boom. Our spaces have are visibly more diverse today, meaning we find ourselves in company of people who are diagonally opposite to our line of thought, context, socioeconomic background, political, religious, sexual beliefs. And I feel that we have failed miserably in capitalizing this degree of diversity that exists in a room. And safe spaces are an opportunity for us to understand that diversity. Lastly, I feel it's important to build these safe spaces because they help us see the patterns of oppression across multiple areas. When we let people who have been oppressed for a really long time speak up in these spaces, we understand where we went wrong as a civilization. And we have an opportunity to craft a better world, a world that we will be leaving for the generations to come. The idea of creating a safe space is really well intentioned. I can keep giving you reasons of why we should invest time, energy in building these safe spaces across the areas we exist in. But just saying that a space is a safe space hardly adds anything. So then the question is, what do we do in our capacity as an everyday individual to be able to create these spaces for others? Because just saying doesn't necessarily translate. I can say that it's a safe space, it doesn't necessarily make it a safe space unless we adhere to a common code of conduct. And here are a few principles that I have distilled for myself. The first one is to understand diversity. Unless we are curious enough to understand the degree of diversity that exists in a room, we'll not be able to create a safe space. It first starts from asking questions, being inquisitive. For me as a teacher, it started when I asked my kids, you know, what is it that you think I should be improving on? And that gave me a lens to see the diversity of opinions that existed. Children who were not great at academics wanted to be great at academics, but they also thought that they are good at sports and it should be acknowledged equally. So as long as we do not understand the degree of diversity that exists in the room, it's difficult to build a safe space. The second is to listen actively. It's one of the most toughest things to do and is also one of the most used words in the past 5 to 7 years. Active listening has climbed up the hierarchy of corporates to becoming like one of the most important words when they're coaching their managers to be more efficient. And by listening actively, I mean it's not only the conversations that are happening within the group or a safe space, but it's also the conversations that are not happening that explicitly. These can be like the undertones of it. These can be a person giving a shrug on a comment or passing a sexist remark. But how do we listen very actively to whatever is going on in the space that we are present forms a pillar of creating a safe space. Modeling vulnerability. After I asked my children, what should I be improving on? I sat with them. I did small and large group discussions to tell them my story, where I came from and why, what made me do what I did. Of course, it was not a justification. It was me modeling my vulnerability in a way that children understand that what has gone on. And then together we can work towards it. Once I was able to do that, I could form connections to children who felt that there was no connection between them and me. And I feel creating safe spaces requires us to model that degree of vulnerability. And lastly, calling out unhealthy behavior. I think it takes huge amount of courage to call out unhealthy and unwanted behaviors from our friends, from our family, that violates the concept of a safe space. And to be able to do that, we'll have to make gradual progresses. We'll have to start calling it out on WhatsApp groups, on Instagram or Facebook, and then bring it inside our bedrooms, our boardrooms, our drawing rooms, the dinner table conversations we have. And then it will manifest into a society where our schools and colleges and boardrooms and companies and organizations and startups start practicing this courage of calling out a behavior that is not required within a space. From my work of years of working in education, I have seen children who were most vocal turn into adolescents, who felt insecure, pushed to feel neglected, turning to drugs and unable to open freely. But my experience has also taught me that if we want a society that thrives on the diversity of ideas, generates human-centered solutions to complex personal and social problems that exist, and takes us a step forward to the utopian dream, we cannot do that without safe spaces that I talk of. And the onus to create that safe space lies with us. With consistently practicing some of the principles that I talked about, along with prioritizing self-care, reaching out to people in times of crisis, especially people that we feel can hold that space for us. Every time I have felt vulnerable, I have had people who have held me in a way that I can share, in a way that I can grow. Collectively, I feel as a society, there is a need to start a revolution that leads to rethinking our spaces and our contribution into making these spaces safe. The idea for this is to reinstate a culture that transcends the boundary of power and privilege. And within those spaces, then we'll be able to create a society that gives equal opportunity to everyone to tell their story, no matter where they come from. Thank you.